Some questions don't arise naturally. What would Moses have done with a tablet computer instead of, you know, tablets? Would a horse still be a horse if it had toes instead of hooves? And, the subject here, what would it be like if Infiniti stretched the QX50's wheelbase by 3.2 inches? The difference between those first two rhetorical questions and that last one is that Infiniti has in fact gone and stretched the QX50's wheelbase by 3.2 inches for 2016. So here's the answer to a question you never thought of and never asked about a relatively obscure crossover. First, let's clear up some things. The QX50 is the SUV-ish thing formerly known as the AX37 before Infiniti decided to make its inscrutable naming system 44% more inscrutable by starting everything with a Q. And before it was the EX37, it was the EX35. The EX35 was introduced way back in 2007 when the first iPhone was the only iPhone, and it seemed inevitable that Hillary Clinton would be the Democratic nominee for President of the United States. Some things haven't changed. Whatever it has been called, the QX's greatest strengths are mechanical. Specifically, those are Nissan's FM front mid-engine vehicle platform and the VQ series V6 engine. The FM bones that underpin the QX also are used as the basis for the Nissan 370Z and Infiniti's best-selling sedan, the Q50. Every FM-based vehicle benefits from excellent weight distribution thanks to the engine's placement behind the front axle centerline. And they all use control arm front and multi-link rear suspension setups. It's a platform that is designed to deliver balanced handling and a high-performance driving experience, and that carries over to the QX50. The VQ series V6 has been a charismatic, if somewhat coarse, engine from the moment it first appeared in North America in 3.0-liter form and making 190 horsepower under the hood of the 1995 Nissan Maxima. The lyrically named VQ37 VHR in the QX now displaces 3.7 liters and is rated at 325 horsepower despite lacking any forced induction or leading-edge technologies such as direct fuel injection. As in other FM-based machines, the V6 is mounted longitudinally in the QX50 in the traditional rear-wheel drive configuration. Prices for QX50 start at $35,445 for the rear drive version and $36,845 for the all-wheel drive model. Throw everything at one, the $2,000 premium plus, $2,400 deluxe touring, and $2,750 technology packages, plus pearless and paint, the only standalone choice at $500, and the price still falls just shy of $45,000.
Phones, Babylon's can't